The thing that convinced me that Jesus is not God is that Jesus died on the cross. Now, although this may seem really simple, let me explain why this is so convincing. So it's a simple logical argument. The first premise is that God cannot die. We see this in 1 Timothy 6:16, where it says God alone has immortality. The second premise is that Jesus died. We see that all throughout the New Testament in 1 Corinthians 15:3 and Romans 5:8, all throughout, we see that Jesus died on the cross. So the conclusion is that Jesus is not God. You have two premises: God cannot die, Jesus died, therefore Jesus is not God. Now, let's talk about some common Trinitarian explanations of this problem. The first one is to say that just Jesus' human nature died. Say, well, no, he has a God nature and a human nature, but just his human nature died. Let's talk about why that doesn't really work. First, it goes against the Council of Chalcedon. So the Council of Chalcedon is this council that was held in 451. It's an Orthodox council. It's one of the seven ecumenical councils. In this council, they concluded that Jesus is acknowledged in two natures unconfusedly, unchangeably, indivisibly, inseparably. Not as though he were parted or divided into two persons, but one in the selfsame and only begotten God, Word, Lord, Jesus Christ. So, in this definition, they say that you cannot split apart the natures of Christ. They're inseparable. But that's exactly what these Trinitarians do, and that's what I used to do with the death of Christ on the cross. I would just simply split apart his natures and say, well, yeah, it's just his human nature that died. So if you're comfortable going against this Orthodox Trinitarian council, you're welcome to do that. But you're going against an Orthodox Trinitarian council. The second reason why this doesn't really work is that to say that just the human nature of Jesus died is to actually deny that the Trinitarian Jesus died. Now, this may be a little complex, but let me explain. In Mark 1:9, we read, "And it came to pass in those days that Jesus came from Nazareth of Galilee, and was baptized by John in the Jordan." So this is just a normal, common New Testament passage that talks about Jesus, right? I'm using this to explain who is Jesus. So a Trinitarian would read this and understand this to be their understanding of Jesus, that he has two natures. He's fully God and fully man. So he's a two-natured Jesus. That's who they're understanding Jesus to be. However, when we get to the death of Christ on the cross, he's the one-natured Jesus. So only one nature of Jesus dies on the cross. Do you see the problem? That's just a different Jesus. If you are consistently reading the New Testament and understanding Jesus to have two natures by identity, that's who he is. He has two natures. Then to say that the one nature of Jesus died on the cross is to say that it's a different Jesus who died on the cross. That's not Jesus. If you're defining Jesus as having two natures, and you say only one nature died on the cross, then that means Jesus did not die on the cross. So I think we should really take that into consideration. Lastly, there's nothing in Scripture that defines Jesus as having two natures. He's never once spoken of as having two natures, two wills, two selves, two essences, nothing like that. The Scriptures consistently define him as a man, not as a God-man. He is the man attested by God. He is called the one mediator between God and man, the man, Christ Jesus. The Scriptures are not silent about identifying who Jesus is. They just don't identify him as a God-man. They identify him as a man. So that should make us stop and think for a second. How could the Scriptures spend more time talking about meat sacrificed to idols in 1 Corinthians than talking about the two natures of Christ, if that is an essential doctrine for salvation? The New Testament authors are scarily silent about that. That should make us pause for a second. Maybe they're defining him in a different way. Maybe they're not defining him as a God-man, but just as a man. So to explain away the death of Christ using the two natures and splitting apart his natures simply doesn't work, and it's not found in Scripture. So another reason, an explanation that Trinitarians give to explain how Jesus could die and still be God, is that they'll say, well, the death of Christ is a mystery. Now, First, I want us to step back and think, do we really want to base our whole faith on a mystery? Does the New Testament call us to base our faith on a mystery? No, it calls us to base our faith on the real physical life, death, and resurrection of Jesus. So if we're appealing to mystery, maybe we're missing the mark a little bit. And secondly, I'd like to point out that I don't think that that's actually a mystery. So most people that I know that appeal to mystery accept premise one and premise two. They accept that God cannot die and that Jesus died, but then they don't want to accept the conclusion that therefore Jesus is not God. So I think when we step back, we need to really realize, what are we doing when we're saying it's a mystery? Are we just denying a conclusion that we don't want to conclude? Or are we denying one of the premises? Because that's the only other way around this. You either have to deny the premises or accept the conclusion. Now, I'm not asking you to abandon your faith, but to let the scriptures speak louder than your theology. Jesus did die on the cross, and he was raised from the dead. It's amazing news that should never get old. But this is only possible because he is not God. Thanks so much for listening.